Hi there, this is Teresa. Welcome back to the channel. We are going to do a general collective reading. The person that is in your heart, what is the energy surrounding you and the situation with this person? Keep in mind, this is a general collective reading. Only take what resonates, leave the rest. If you want your own personalized in-depth reading, my website is timelessdivinetarot.com. I do have a 24 to 48 hour turnaround. All right, let's see, what is your energy regarding the situation with you and your person? Okay, Leo matters. You could be in the middle of a separation or a divorce with this person. You feel like you haven't been justified. Things have not been fair. Things have not been equal and balanced with your person. Fated meeting. You feel like maybe everything has happened the way it's supposed to be, that maybe there is a divide or separation here, that at one point maybe you felt like it was destiny that you were with this person, and now maybe you feel like it's meant to be that you're not with this person. There is something about secret crush here. You could be crushing on somebody else while in separation with your person. There's somebody else you're admiring. Let's see your person's energy. Divine timing. See, your person feels like everything is happening the way it's supposed to, but maybe you are the right person, but they understand for you not waiting for them because they've made wrong choices or wrong decisions. Liquid courage. Your person could be somebody who has substance issues. Maybe they use vices or they use other things that make their confidence feel boost, but it doesn't boost their confidence. Really, what it does is it makes them act stupid or act foolish. They maybe act ridiculous if they're drinking or doing drugs or they're doing a lot of gambling. Maybe they have other addictions. Signs and synchronicities. The universe is showing your person some signs about their behavior. It's not about divine timing. It is all about this person is maybe impacted the financial status of your relationship. Maybe their addictions have taken you through the ringer, and that could be why maybe you're in legal separation or you're in divorce. So let's find out, what are your intentions versus your person's intentions, and what's going to be the likely outcome between the collective and their person? All right, your intentions. Three of Cups in reverse. So you don't want to get together with this person. You don't want to talk about it. You're kind of done and over with it. The Death card is in reverse. So things have not been resolved. Even though maybe you have filed for divorce, you filed for legal separation, or you've just made the justified decision that things aren't fair, this Death in reverse, you still are holding on that something's not complete. It's not over. It could be that maybe their belongings are still in your home, or you are still thinking about them, so you feel like it's not resolved. I also have the Knight of Coins in reverse, Knight of Pentacles. So you're not going towards this person with any type of stability, security, or commitment. You're holding back. You're holding your own. Let's see your person's intentions. Five of Cups in reverse. They want to try to recover this emotional loss that they feel, this void that they're feeling in their heart. Ten of Swords. They feel defeated because of their behavior, because of what they thought made them confident really made them very insecure. And we've got the Six of Cups in reverse. They also feel that there is an unfinished business to a certain extent. Maybe you have children together. Maybe you've known each other since childhood. Maybe there's a long history here. Let's see what's going to be the likely outcome between the collective and their person. Faith in reverse. So it looks like both of you are losing faith. You don't have a lot of hope or optimism that this is going to work out. Ten of Pentacles in reverse. So there is definitely history here. There's money and finances that have been impacted in the negative light. And we do have the Lovers. So you could feel like you are soulmates. You could feel like you're karmic soulmates, that maybe this person's a karmic to you or you're karmic to them. Either way, there is still a bond that the two of you feel. There's something that's unresolved below the surface. Even though on top level or the front that both of you are putting on, that it's over and it's done, there's still something below the surface that's not over as far as this bond. But it does look like both of you are going to keep your guard up. You're on the defense. Maybe you've blocked each other. You don't want to talk to each other. You don't want to see each other. There's a lot of anger in this reading. And Eight of Wands in reverse. There's no communication at all. You're in no contact. There is silence between the two of you. So what is the best advice or guidance for the collective at this time in this situation? Page of Coins. Queen of Wands in reverse. Eight of Cups in reverse. If you feel like you need to return back to this person, gain your sense of stability and security about what your expectations are if you do try to come back. We do have the Seven of Swords hidden at the bottom of the deck. So there's some dishonesty here about that it's over. However, it does feel like you would like your person to return to you, but you're not going to take the lead. Your advice is not to take the lead. If your person is the one who stepped out of the connection or did things that put you in a compromising position, maybe you potentially are losing your car or your home, or maybe potentially you could have almost lost your job over the situation with your significant other or your partner. Those are things that cannot be taken back. And so the universe wants you to think long and hard. Don't take the lead to go towards your person. Maintain your stance. Wait to see if your person corrects their course. See if they do the right thing and try to rectify and resolve the situation. But allowing things to sit for right now is the best key of advice. Don't return into the situation quite yet, because your person is not coming towards you yet either. There's almost like a cooling off period that's happening between the two of you that is needed. With that Seven of Swords, you both could be lying to yourselves that it is over, but there's a heavy energy that even though it may be over on the outside, on the inside, it's not over yet. And it could be because there are emotions that need to be worked through on both sides. Okay, collective, that is what I have for you. If you do want your own personalized in-depth reading, my website's timelessdivinetarot.com. I do have a 24 to 48 hour turnaround. Have a great day. Bye.